as it moves to the north and east. I'm going to get in here a little bit and see if I can get. We're in a situation where we've got a couple of radar beams that are looking at this storm kind of at really high levels, and they're sort of, it's what we call range folding. We're right in between that, so we're not able to get a real good look right on this border at what is happening with the velocity. But let's just have a peek here. I'm going to look first from one of the radars, and it's kind of hard to see. What we've got is some pretty strong winds for sure, and I've been watching this throughout the afternoon and evening, that we've seen wind gusts anywhere between 45 to 60 miles per hour with this. I don't see any rotation with this, but again, remember what I was just telling you. We're pretty high up in the atmosphere with this storm because of what's happening with the radars where they intersect here right at this particular area between Alexander and Wilkes County. We're getting also just really strong winds with this that are coming out easily in excess of 40 miles an hour. So whether there is a tornado or not, what we do know is that there is the potential that we could have some damaging winds with this. Let me go back in again and just get into a position where we can kind of move around and look at some of the streets. Remember, the safe place in your home is going to be on the lowest floor, just like I was talking about a few minutes ago. Best to maybe, if you're heading to bed, you may want to just sleep on that lowest floor for the next couple of hours. I know it'll be hard to sleep because you've got the noise and, of course, the thought that maybe there is a tornadic activity at least through midnight or so. I don't think the Storm Prediction Center will extend this tornado watch. I do think these storms are going to be collapsing with time over the next hour or two, but we are definitely in that boomer community. So that is along Highway 18, and that runs out of Wilkesboro, goes out by the lake there, and you can see a pretty intense area of heavy rain. So you're at High Rock Road and also Falls Road. There's Price Road there, Boone Gap Road, also Moravian Falls, and it's moving really quickly to the northeast. I think I got a speed of about 45 miles an hour. So let me go ahead and put, and by the way, you're noticing this second little area. Let me see if I can point that out to you a little bit better. This little area right here on the bottom of this storm is where we're talking about maybe seeing that rotation. Just from looking at this kidney bean shape, when you start to get that separation like that, that's the area that I'm most concerned about. So let me go ahead and put a track on this, and I think I'll have to kind of back out to do that, because we are going so fast. Let's do northeast at about 45 miles an hour. This gives you an idea of some of the things that are in the path of this storm. Sugarloaf School, we've got Gilreath, we've got Wright School, we've got Windy Gap, all in the path of this storm within the next little bit. And I actually want to get a little closer than I was just then in case we're missing some of the communities in that zone. Moravian Falls, Roaring River, also in that general area with this storm moving northeast. Again, it is moving northeast at about 45 miles an hour. That was the case with the storm that we had earlier that moved through Randolph County, where we had that tornado warning. We never did get any confirmation on the ground of that. We had news crews that went into Randolph County. We did not see any damage from that. It was a more rural area, so it's possible. We had a funnel cloud. It's going to be really difficult this time of night to see a funnel cloud, of course. It's also going to be really difficult to find any damage. So I just want to encourage you, if you are in Wilkes County, if you're in that southwestern part of the county, we really need you to get into your safe place as this storm is moving through. I've been watching, Weather Service folks have been tracking these storms all evening, and out of the Greenville-Spartanburg area, they have had a number of warnings tonight, and they have had some damage. In Burke County around Morganton, they had damage too, and you see that line that extends back to the south and west. So right now there are two storms. One that is over Wilkes that may be producing a tornado. Another one that is just south of Morganton that has produced a separate warning that goes over toward Hickory. I want to see if we're going to get a better view. The more this moves to the northeast, we should get a little bit of a better view on whether or not we have any kind of rotation with this. It's going to be hard to see, I'll be honest with you, because of the location. We are starting to get just a little bit popping in here. As it gets a little bit closer to that Wilkes line, we should be able to get a good view of it. It's a little hard to see from the area that we are in right now. Getting a new information here. That's an update. They've expired the tornado warning for Alexander and for Burke counties. Let me flip you back over to the radar.
Do we know how long this warning is in effect for?
It is up until 11:30. So
okay,
this,
another 20 minutes.
Yes, so this one will be up until 11:30. I've not seen them cancel them this evening. They've been pretty long-lived warnings once the warnings go out. So I would anticipate that we're talking about this being active for the next, at least for the next 15 minutes, if not the next half hour. I want to show again some streets where we're talking about. We're right on the border. Actually, you see the red lines through the middle here. That's actually the county line. And we're talking about the area that is, I would say right, oops, I keep picking the wrong thing, folks. Bear with me. Let me clear that off. Too many gadgets to choose from. Let's see. All right, here we go. This area right here is what I'm most concerned about, having that rotation. And you're getting a new sweep there. And in particular, the little protrusion that I'm seeing right here makes me a little bit nervous too. So we're kind of getting ready to cross over. It looks like Highway 16 there that runs south of Wilkesboro. And again, let me clear this off and we'll take you out a little bit further so we can get our bearings again and put this into motion, because I think that's going to be helpful for folks. And Kenny, we always tell folks that, you know, make sure that you get to the lowest floor. If you have a basement, that's a good place to be. If you have a bathroom, if you don't have a basement, maybe a bathroom on the lowest floor. We always tell folks that bathtub is a good place to head in and make sure you're cuddled up. And I can imagine that there are folks that are real scared tonight in Wilkes County with kids. It's bedtime, and yeah, it's time to get them up, get them moving, and get them into a place where they need to be safe, which is on the lowest floor.
I can't remember if it was you or Michelle who mentioned earlier, speaking of little kids, if you have a bike helmet
right
in the garage or,
yeah,
or a batting helmet, football,
yeah,
something that could protect your head,
right,
particularly if you don't have a you know, deep down
right
basement where you feel comfortable, that might not be a terrible idea.
No, I think that's an excellent idea. It's often what I tell students when I go out and speak in the classrooms is, you know, you're going to want to protect your head, because most folks are not, I say to them, you're not picked up and carried away necessarily by a tornado, but something is thrown into you and could hurt you. So you want to make sure you're buffeting yourself with pillows and blankets and protecting yourself that way, covering your head in particular, mm-hmm, head injuries oftentimes with tornadoes too. We definitely have strong winds with this. We are along Highway 16, Kenny, so I was just looking at that just to give you an idea. We're south of Wilkesboro. We're between the community of Boomer, which is actually not far from where the lake sits there, southwest of Wilkesboro, and then sort of near that old Gilruth community headed up toward 421. So if you're in Windy Gap, if you're in Delplain, if you're in Wilkesboro, this potential tornado-producing storm is moving northeast at about 45 miles an hour. So let me put another track on this for you.
Generally speaking, a storm, a tornado such as this that is moving quicker, is that, and I guess anything can do any kind of damage, even if it's not a tornado, straight line winds can do damage. Would we prefer to see one that moves quickly or one that moves slowly, or does it not really matter?
It doesn't necessarily matter. I think with most of these supercells, if it's long lived and it is on the ground and it's moving fast, you have to think about the wind that is rotating plus the forward speed and sort of add those together, and then you get that total wind impact, which may be 80 or 90 miles an hour. The other thing though that you can also think about is if the storm is just producing a mesocyclone, which this one might be doing, that is just that low-hanging cloud that hasn't touched down and is moving quickly, then let's get it out of here fast,
right?
We want it to move through very quickly for that case. So there's different ways to sort of look at that. I do know, though, that with the concern tonight, this is not one of those tornado warnings that I'm sitting here on TV saying, it's just, you know, just a caution. You know, we've had active tornado warnings all day today. We've been real lucky that we haven't had any touchdowns, so to speak, but we could have that happen. And it doesn't take a whole lot to get the wind to push down out of a thunderstorm and kind of drive that mesocyclone down to the ground, even if it is just briefly. So that's a concern.
And I've heard you say this so many times over the years, the tornado warning after dark at
yeah
a time of night when some people may already be asleep, that is absolutely the worst kind of one. You'd rather have it at 1 in the afternoon than 11:15 at night, for obvious reasons.
Yeah, and I'll be real honest with you. When we were on the air at 6 o'clock, it really didn't look like this was going to be an active night for the mountains and foothills. It looked like it was going to be a little more focused down east over the triad, but just a little bit of a shift in that frontal position, and then the approach of the cold front, and the air just still unstable enough with the shear that we talked about earlier is enabling that area to kind of build back into the mountains and foothills. So I'm hopeful that even folks in Wilkes and Surrey County, obviously you've probably been woken up by the heavy rain and the lightning, but hopefully still have your active warnings, a way to get your warnings through the WXI 12 News app. You can get them online. We post those warnings as well on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We're trying to get the message out to you any way that we can. Just to make sure that you know, and hopefully folks were awakened by their alert system, NOAA Weather Radio, and they're watching, and we can kind of talk you through this. Let me stop this right now on the last image, and this is Brocktown Road that is right in the center of this cell. So that's where the incredible heavy rain is coming down right now. I haven't been able to get a real good tornado signature. There it is. Okay, so it is popping up now. I had to wait for a couple sweeps, folks, because we really were in that situation where what I was telling you about range folding, where the two radar sites are sort of meeting at a higher point. And this still is a pretty high radar sweep point, meaning that this could be happening hundreds of feet up in the clouds still, or even just 100 feet off the ground, because when you think about a radar beam going out over space and the Earth is curving, that gets higher and higher as it goes. So right now we may be looking a little bit higher up into the storm where there is that mesocyclone and that rotation. That's what I'm hopeful for. I haven't seen a tightening of that, meaning as I'm looking at these red and green squares, I see kind of a wide area here. I'd look for that to get really tight. I've only seen that once today, and that was farther south in the Greenville-Spartanburg market, where just for a couple of sweeps you saw a real tightening and then it went away. And that's what I was talking about with that mesocyclone. If it can be spinning or a big funnel cloud and then just tighten for a second, get pushed down to the ground and then come right back up. That's what the concern is for. That's why we're on the air right now. That's why I'm telling you to make sure that you're in your safe place, that you're in your basement or you're on the lowest floor.
Just got a note in my ear from our producer. We've been making calls to various emergency responder folks in and around Wilkes County, and the latest word, and we hope this remains the latest word, no specific damage.
Good.
In the county. There are some branches down, things, debris scattered about, but no hotspot or troublesome street, area, neighborhood, building, structure, et cetera,
right,
et cetera, that crews are responding to and responding to with concern.
Good.
So that is good, and perhaps an indication that this is that mesocyclone that you
right.
talked about, that there's
right.
all kinds of crazy stuff going on,
right.
but it's very high up in
right.
the sky. It's loud, it's frightening, it has us on television right now, but the threat to people and homes may not be imminent.
Right.
We
and
hope that's the case.
It's almost impossible to predict
right.
when that might come down to the ground. We're seeing definitely some very strong winds with this, Kenny. You can see some of the winds that are showing up that are in excess of about 40 miles an hour. And then the forward speed of this storm is also 45 miles an hour. So you're getting some wind gusts with that. You do have a little bit of rotation here. It's a little lopsided, meaning I've got a 10 mile per hour wind against a 40 mile an hour wind. So it makes me think, you know, that most of the wind is coming like this in this direction and being blown that way, but you've got a little bit of a spin-off that's happening as you go up higher in the atmosphere. But I do want to show you the roads that are in the path of this storm. We're south of Moravian Falls. We're around Price Road. We are also on Brocktown Road, Country Club Road there near Moravian Falls, Oakwoods Community, Orchard Road. If I'm calling your name out, your street out, your city out, you need to be in your safe place near the Call Community, just east of Wilkesboro along Highway 421, not too far from the Speedway, of course, that's off just to the east of there. And you can see Windy Gap as well. So these areas that are showing up here on the screen, Mount Sinai Road, Old Salisbury Road, or Highway 115, this is moving to the northeast in your general direction. And let me put some motion on it so we can get an idea. of that sort of spinning around. You're seeing it coming through. It's a little bit slow and hard to, or I should say a little bit quick. So let me slow it down just a little bit so you can see that. And you can see the lake there that is just west of Wilkesboro. So we're now just east of there, just east of Boomer. And that area is sort of being picked up on the radar just south of Moravian Falls. Go back to our live radar. We have a tornado warning that is up until now. It looks like they may have extended that warning to 11:45, Kenny. At least that's what the equipment here is telling me. I'm going to look for verification on that.
And I'm seeing a couple of things, too, that might be worth pointing out. We just had a story before this tornado warning kicked in about power outages from the Department of Public Safety. Within just the last minute, Allegheny County has joined the map here in terms of one of the greatest areas of power outages. Almost 1,600 people out in Allegheny County. That's out of about 5,500 total statewide. Allegheny County, if you're not necessarily familiar with the geography to the west, is the county directly north of Wilkes County.
Correct.
Right now, DPS only reporting 130 outages in Wilkes County, although the emergency responders, when we talked to them a minute ago, said that there were some power lines down as well. This might be a great time to remind people that if you do still have your power and you have been awakened by this and may have a little bit of difficulty getting immediately back to bed, charge up your electronics right now. Charge up laptops and tablets and phones and things of that nature so that in the event that you do lose power, even if it's for a short period of time, you have some level of charge and you can be connected to us and to neighbors and friends and to emergency services and things of that nature. If you're not someone who sits with your phone on your nightstand charging all night, maybe a good time to do that if you have not lost power just yet. But again, we are in a situation where within the last, I think, 10 or 15 minutes, we were only about 5 minutes into the 11 o'clock newscast, if I'm not mistaken, when this tornado warning was issued for Wilkes County. It was initially due to expire around 11:30. I believe that has been extended now until 11:45. We will remain on television wall to wall until we do get the all clear, until this warning does indeed expire. And it's one of the reasons that Laney and Michelle and others were warning that even though the early stuff moved through the eastern part of the market earlier in the evening, we couldn't let our guard down just yet. And this is precisely why we've seen almost both ends of the state, or both ends of the viewing area anyway,
right,
dealing with issues about 5-6 hours apart.
Oh yeah, definitely. And I was just checking on that tornado warning too. It is 11:30. I had accidentally clicked on the one that was just southwest of that for 11:45. So it is 11:30. And just one thing that I'm noticing just by looking at the radar loop here is I can tell that the storm is, you know, not in an area that is as conducive for it to be, you know, a big potent storm. You can see that it has weakened some as it has worked its way from Lenore up toward Wilkesboro. Just the size of it, it has shrunk some. The potency of it, the intensity of it, the heavy rain component has sort of shrunk down with it, and not seeing as much lightning with it. Still heavy rain, still probably having some rotation with it, but the trend tonight has been for these storms to come up and then to sort of fizzle out a little bit as they move into Wilkes and to Surry County. So I'm hopeful that here in the next 5, 6, 7 minutes, as this warning should be allowed to expire, that we'll continue to see kind of a weakening with it and that we won't see it sort of revamp, because that can happen with those supercell storms too. It can be really intense, sort of look like it's dying and then come back and look like it's dying and come back. So we'll want to watch this closely, and I think having this warning, we're at 11:24 now until 11:30, will help give us a really good idea of whether or not it's going to continue. Let me go back to the velocity and seeing that is now looking more unidirectional, meaning that I'm seeing nothing for the most part but green squares, meaning that wind is going in one direction, maybe damaging winds with that. We definitely have some 40, 45 mile per hour winds with that. We may not have any gusts to 60 or so, which would make that technically sort of a damaging wind storm. But I do see less of that opposing wind that would indicate that we're having some rotation. So that's good news. We're just east of Moravian Falls now. We'll wait for another sweep on that. That will help us. And also kind of look at another view of the radar. And you can see the storm now just east of Wilkesboro over the Call community. So that's how quickly it's moving at 45 miles an hour. So it's already crossing over Highway 115 and then moving toward the Call community. There is this little dangling protrusion here that I don't like too much that is extending down toward Bethany Church Road. We'll keep a close eye on that to see if that indeed is going to produce more of a signature from the velocity standpoint, because it definitely doesn't look great on the screen right now from my perspective, seeing that sort of hook dangling to the south of that. But we'll continue to look at it and make sure that we're not getting a tightening of this, more so a rotation that is a lot tighter. If anything, it could be very weak as it's pushing down closer to the ground. But I'd like to see more red kind of filling in here just below that 421 sign. And I'll wait for some more information to come in on this radar to tell me if we're indeed seeing that tightening that we're concerned about, that you would see with that sort of hook scenario. And again, now back to kind of more of a rounding of that as well. Go ahead, Kenny.
While you had that wide view up there, one thing I wanted to make you aware of, we're receiving a few reports from viewers, and I wanted to sort of get this in your area as well. People are reporting potential tornado touchdowns in Carroll County, Virginia. We're hearing potentially houses destroyed and some roads impassable. That line is extraordinarily long, or at least it appears that way to me, someone, a layperson in all of this, but that is a long line of nasty different colors extending from the mountains all the way well up into part of the viewing area up north of the border in Virginia.
Yeah, and we were looking at a severe thunderstorm warning. I think it was when we were on the air at 10 o'clock. There was a severe thunderstorm warning for part of Carroll and part of Grayson County. They chose not to issue a tornado warning with that. But with all severe thunderstorms, especially if you're in a tornado watch, there's always the possibility that you could have a tornado. Now, some of that damage that you're hearing about could also be straight line winds, so we don't know that. I did see some really strong winds with that severe thunderstorm that went through Carroll and Grayson counties. I think I saw at one point a 65 mile an hour wind just right on the escarpment there, right along the Blue Ridge, and I did see some of that kind of going up in that general direction. I'm sorry, you're getting some information now?
Not immediately. No, okay. We're just talking about the next few minutes here and okay. Checking
right,
in
no
on
problem.
The outages, and still 11:30. Is that what we're still thinking for
right now?
This has not been extended to the best of your knowledge, although it still could be.
Yeah, I just got a new update. Note: still 11:30. Located near Windy Gap, moving northeast at 45. So nothing major has changed with that.
Okay.
We'll look at this again.
We can always get information from you out there. Please do not put yourself or any family members in a position where you could potentially suffer any kind of harm. But if you do happen to see anything interesting that's worthy of a photograph or some video, you can always send that to newstips, newstips, at WXII12.com. You can also message us on Facebook or through other various social media. But please, it bears repeating, do not even consider putting yourself or your family in any harm's way just to be a storm chaser. We obviously have a lot of equipment here and a lot of tools and a lot of knowledgeable folks who can give you kind of the big picture view and also the hyper local view as we zoom in. But right now, very challenging because it is the middle of the night practically, difficult to bring you any images of this. And perhaps, again, I'm an optimist here, but perhaps the fact that we're not being inundated already with images of damage, perhaps an indicator that there has not been a whole lot of damage yet. As of last check with the folks, the emergency responders in Wilkes County, no specific damage that they were aware of, just some branches down
and
some power
lines. And they're saying they're going to let this expire at 11:30.
Okay.
We do have a little bit of a velocity signature that is showing up. up there. Gives me a little bit of concern. It's kind of weak, though. The trend has been for this storm to sort of weaken. Here we go. Here it comes. They're actually going to extend that now for Surrey, Carroll, and Patrick County. Tornado warning. Located over Mount Airy now. So while this is happening, something else is developing just to the northeast. So let's look at that. And I'm going to need a second just to go turn off all those alarms, or you'll have to listen to those for a while. But let me show you where it is. This is a radar indicated Surrey, Carroll, and Patrick. Now, let's not confuse people. The damage that you were talking about earlier, Kenny, was much earlier. That's right. Not what's happening right now, even though Carroll County does appear to be in that zone. You can see the red brush community. The only thing I've got with this one is a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado located over Mount Airy, moving northeast at 45 miles an hour. And you can see it does have lightning with it, as well as some heavy precipitation with it. And yes, more of a intact signature showing up here, what we like to call gate to gate or side by side winds. This one looks more like a tornado to me, textbook wise. I don't have the guarantees because I don't have the ground truth and I'm not out there. I have the knowledge to look at this and say that this definitely looks like a tornado producing storm, and it may be producing a tornado right now. So we are at Toast Road. We are on Highway 89 and 52. So where those two intersect is where I am seeing that right now, that rotation that is inbound and outbound. So we got a velocity of 14 against a velocity of about 41. So we have some strong winds with this too, but we also have that rotation with it. So folks, you need to seek your safe shelter now. Go ahead and put up that information, because that is where you need to be. Kenny, can you take that over for me so I can fix something over here real quick?
I certainly can. If you're just turning on your television set, if you're hearing noises outside that have woken you or your family up, we are in a tornado warning right now for Surrey County, as well as Carroll County, Virginia, and Patrick County, Virginia. Laney is particularly concerned about the area of Toast Road, Highway 89 and 52. If this is where you live, if this is where a loved one lives, go to a basement or a safe room in your home. If you do not have a basement, a bathroom, a closet, something on the lowest floor is your best bet. Stay away from windows, stay away from doors. If you have children, it is not a terrible idea to perhaps find a bike helmet, a football, baseball helmet, something that they can put over their heads. You could put something over your head. That could be a couch cushion. That can be a thick pillow. That can be anything to potentially protect yourself. As Laney mentioned before, she does so many school visits, and she tells children who have questions about severe weather and tornadoes in particular that you are not likely to be lifted up and dropped somewhere by a tornado. If you are unfortunate enough to be injured in a tornado, the more likely scenario is going to be something falling onto you. So that is why, if you are able to protect your head with some type of apparatus, that is advisable to do that. Laney, just for clarification, this new tornado warning for Surrey County and a few counties in the WXII viewing area that are just over the border in Virginia, is this a warning in addition to the one that we saw earlier in Wilkes, or now that we're on the other side of 11:30, has the one for Wilkes expired? Is this the same line of storms?
It is two different storms, and the Wilkes County storm was allowed to expire because it was showing some signs of weakening. The one in Surrey County has just sort of developed, and we're seeing definitely a signature from it that looks like we have got a possible tornado that may be a funnel cloud possibly touching down. Let me get in here and show you a view of that. The first storm we want to go up, we'll show you this one, which is coming out of Hickory, not quite into Wilkes County. That is a tornado warning, so we'll keep an eye on that one. But this one is imminent right now, and this storm has been moving northeast also at 45 miles an hour and is kind of developed. You can see it. Let me take you real slowly just over the last half an hour and just see how quickly this one has developed. As we go back over 45 minutes, you see it was nothing there west of Dobson, and all of a sudden intensifying and then producing a tornado. So you can follow that track as it developed. So this is how quickly these storms are sort of moving and developing into something bigger. And this right now is a tornado warning. And this tornado warning is up until midnight, so until 12 a.m. And we'll stop this again, go in, and I want to do a little bit of street level mapping for you because we are definitely, you see all of the roads that are coming up here. This is really concerning to me because we do have a very populated area here, and we do have what appears to be side-by-side rotation, and that area right there is the area that makes me believe we may have some sort of tornadic activity taking place here. So Green Hill Road, just north of downtown Mount Airy, you see all of the streets that are here being seen on our screen. Let me wipe that away because that's going to be not accurate anymore. And go in again. We're talking about South Street. We're along Highway 52, Country Club Road, and Hickory Street up towards Springs Road. And I'll go back out, switch over to our radar again, and do a storm track for you so we can give you an idea of who might be in the path of this storm. This one also moving to the northeast at about 45 miles an hour. So you can see where it puts it at about 45 miles an hour is somewhere up into Patrick County. That's how quickly it's moving. 3 minutes away from Northern Hospital of Surrey County. 4 minutes there. It's right around Mount Airy at this point. Ararat, Meadowfield, and Pike City. These are all communities that are in the path of this storm. Well, go in. I want to go in a little bit tighter. You'll see the community of Ararat, Cana, on Highway 52 right now. If you're waking up and you're hearing this noise, if you're hearing debris hitting the side of your home, you don't have time. You need to get to the lowest place in your home, the lowest level of the home, first floor, bathtub. Make sure you're covering yourself up, protecting yourself. As Kenny was saying, cover yourself up with a helmet. You want to protect yourself from any flying debris. Blankets, pillows, sofa cushions, those are all good protecting agents where you can get in the bathtub, even the whole family, just get in the tub and kind of cover yourself up. If you have a basement, I want you to get into the basement right now. If you're in Mount Airy, if you're up toward Ararat, this storm system heading in your direction, you can ride that storm out as it in your safe place. It should be moving through very, very quickly, and we are hopeful that it is not touching down. I've not had any reports, and I'm assuming our news crews are contacting Surrey County right now in Mount Airy and haven't heard anything yet. I don't expect to, maybe at this minute. A lot of times it takes 5, 10, 15 minutes for us to get any reports after something has passed through. But again, we're in Mount Airy, just northwest of town, near Franklin Road, just north of Redbrush Road. I want to look at the signature again, which has already jumped a good bit. That's how fast it's moving. Still having that sort of side-by-side inbound and outbound winds indicating that there is something rotating between Springs Road, McBride Road, up toward Babbitt Ridge Road, or that may be Rabbit Ridge Road. I can't quite read it. And it is up just toward the border there of Virginia. So we'll see. This is already for Surrey and it is for Surrey County, Carroll County, and Patrick County. I just also saw a message about a strong thunderstorm that is in Surrey, Wilkes, and Yadkin, and that was that second one that was back here moving now. And it also is showing quite a bit of at least broad circulation. So maybe a cloud there that is just sort of spinning at the base of it. They have not put a warning out for that one for Surrey, Wilkes, and Yadkin. But I'll just tell you, just by looking at the storms tonight, you're going to want to go ahead and just bring everybody downstairs and get into a safe place just in case we have either strong damaging winds or a tornado touchdown in either of those areas. The warning is actually up for, I thought I heard a beep there. I was just making sure.
I heard it.
So that is going to be, let's see if that one. So I don't know if that's a reissuance of Surrey because I don't see a new one popping up here yet. So let me double check that real quick. That is, It's just they've just issued it again for Surrey, Carroll, Patrick until midnight. So nothing new other than just sending that warning out again, maybe to trigger more alert systems in the area, just to make sure that folks are getting the warning, because it is dark and a lot of folks are sleeping. This area is just it is Rabbit Ridge Road, it looks like, right on the border. They are north and east of Mount Airy. So that is how quick this is moving, getting ready to head over the border, over Whippoorwill, I can't even say that, Whippoorwill Lane, you can read it, just south of Ararat, and moving northeast.
You know, given the time of day, if you're watching us right now and you're not in the path of anything, but you have a friend, a loved one who is, might not be a terrible idea to give them a phone call and say you need to flip on your television, you flip on your weather radio, and particularly if you hear a road. I mean, we have the technology to zoom in so granular on the street name level. This is about the worst time that these warnings could be issued, because people who work all different times a day, and some people, this may be literally the middle of the night for them right now. Give them a call. Make sure they're okay. Make sure that if they are in this hot spot right now, and the hot spots are changing because this thing is moving so quickly, give them a call. Make sure they're all right. Make sure they're getting where they need to be, that safe space. Perhaps that's an overreaction, but maybe it's not. Unlike the storm that we were dealing with and the warning that we were dealing with earlier in Wilkes County, and especially the stuff that we were dealing with much earlier in the evening, which was primarily rural, not heavily populated. Laney, you're saying locations in Mount Airy that people know and know well. You were talking about the downtown Mount Airy area not too long ago.
Right, and I've got to just really hope that this storm is a funnel cloud, or it is still that rotation up high in the cloud. I'm real hopeful for that, because as you mentioned, there are so many streets that are popping up here beneath where this track was, where we had the rotation showing up. I'm hopeful, like I was talking about earlier with that radar beam being out farther, that maybe it's high enough in the cloud that the rotation is and that it's not touched down. So we're just going to really hope for that tonight. Are you hearing anything new on that?
Our wonderful, hardworking folks behind the scenes are telling me that we just got off the phone with Surrey County Communications. No reports of any damage, no sightings of a tornado yet. So again, middle of the night, much more difficult to see than at 2
absolutely.
In the afternoon. But that is the preferred scenario a thousand times out of a thousand, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And more times than not, I am on TV talking about tornado warnings that don't touch down.
Right.
Right. So that is comforting, and especially not hearing any damage. I think we would have heard something from those communities, because it is, like you said, so heavily populated. So I'm going to hope that. I'm not going to tell you that it's clear, though, because the unfortunate thing, and the thing that I can't do with all of this computer technology, is I can't forecast the minute a gust of wind is going to come down from a thunderstorm. It's impossible for me to tell you the exact moment that's going to happen. And if you've got rotation that's happening in that storm, all it takes is one downdraft, one gust of wind to come down and push that briefly down to the ground. So that's impossible for anyone to predict, and any computer to predict. What I can tell you is the storm does look like it's a little less intense as it's moving northeast. It still is hanging on to that rotation, though, like a supercell would. As it moves northeast, you can still see that rotation. It's a little bit broader now, meaning there's a little bit more space between it, which is good. It was a little tighter when I first looked at it over Mount Airy, which made me think, okay, this one could be trying to actually push to the ground. If it widens out a little bit, that makes me a little more optimistic. But I still think if you're in Ararat, if you're along that Pedigo Ridge Road area, Jones Chapel area, if you're in Carter's Mill, this is heading into your region there in Carroll County, or I should say in Patrick County, and this storm could be doing some damage either way, with strong winds or the potential for some rotation. I want to check back just south and west too. Of the other storms that we have on the screen, this one is just kind of developing here in the Rhonda and Elkin community. Haven't gotten a warning or anything on that. It does appear also to have a little bit of rotation with it. I haven't seen a statement on that one just yet. Actually, I did get a statement on that. A strong thunderstorm over Surrey, East Wilkes, and Yadkin until 12:15. So they're going with strong thunderstorm right now. But you remember at the top of the newscast at 11, we had a strong thunderstorm in Wilkes, and then all of a sudden it went to a tornado warning. So all we need is to see that that sort of signature, that rotation, which you're noticing has disappeared now, we see that sort of hanging on, then the Weather Service is more likely to say, hey, we really need to warn on this. If they warned every time they saw it, trust me, there'd be far more warnings than there are actual tornadoes on the ground. So it's a real close call. It's why they do the warnings, and we just sort of translate them to you. Let me show you the radar again and show you that we do have the tornado warning that is in Mount Airy. And we also have the tornado warning that is southwest of Wilkes County, which is not in our zone. The tornado warning is until midnight for Surrey County. The tornado watch also until midnight for Surrey County. So
about 15 more minutes for each.
Yeah, and I don't know that necessarily these storms will just disappear, you know, in 15 minutes. So the Storm Prediction Center made a late adjustment based on the atmosphere and what was happening and what they saw in the atmosphere to kind of move that risk zone. They are the ones that also issue the watches. So when I saw that sort of shift happening just after dinner time, about 8 o'clock, and we got the new watch out and the new area, I thought, okay, well, now we're in a different ball game because we've seen that instability ahead of that cold front. Three cells that are on the screen, one south of Wilkes, one east of Wilkes near Elkin. Neither of those have tornado warnings, but we do still have the tornado warning for Patrick County, not for Surrey anymore. So you notice that we are now just rain in Mount Airy. As I go in, you're going to see right on the border of Virginia, just south of Ararat, that tornado warning zone is still going to continue there.
We have a Facebook viewer who wrote to us and said it just got really quiet here in Meadows of Dan, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
Have another Facebook viewer question. I'm in Moxville on the line of Yadkinville. Am I okay to go to bed, or do I need to get to a safe space where I am? I think that's a question a lot of people might have. Anytime you turn on your TV and you see this rather than the regular news, your sensors are going to go off a little bit, right?
Yeah, and it does make me a little hesitant if you're in Davie or Forsyth to say, go ahead and go to bed. Because if you look at this map right here, what we do with watches is you'll see the county shaded in. But if you pay attention here, there is a line that is out here, a yellow line, that is the actual watch box zone. And you see that Davie and Forsyth counties are in that zone. They didn't really choose to put the counties in there, but they're in that zone. And I think that region would also probably line up with, and I'm gonna double check, where we have our threat, the slight risk threat, as well as, let me check that tornado threat area. And that may take me a second to find here, but I'll find it. And then we'll look at it too to see where that tornado zone is. And you can see that that sort of lines up with where this activity has been. And it is possible that these storms could continue maybe another hour or two as they move to the east. So I'm not going to say I think that I'm comfortable with you going to sleep. What I would say is go ahead, plan to go to sleep, maybe plan to bring everybody downstairs. If you have a basement, maybe a camp out in the basement tonight, if you can do that. Make sure you have a way to be woken up, right? A weather radio, you've got some way of a notification. It's your computer, it's your phone, it's the television turned on super loud because we'll come on if we have warnings. Just a way to wake up in case this line does hold together for another hour or so and does kind of translate into Yadkin and Davie counties. I'd like to tell you with extreme confidence that it's not going to move into those, but I don't have that 100% confidence on that. So that's a long answer to a question, though, that I think a lot of folks do have, Kenny.
And worth noting, the DPS power outage map is showing that Allegheny now has almost 1,600. That is the worst of any county in the state right now. Wilkes County, which is directly south and was at one point the location of a tornado warning, has about 131. Surry County, county to the direct east of Allegheny County. DPS only reporting one power outage there right now. Not sure if that's necessarily the most up-to-date information, given the fact that Surry County emergency crews told us earlier in the evening that while they did not have any specific damage and certainly nothing widespread, that they did have some branches down, some limbs, and some power lines down. A power line goes down, you're going to lose power somewhere. A reminder for folks, if you are sort of in this limbo position where you're not entirely sure what your next move should be over the next half hour to 2 hours or so, while you're debating what is best for you and what is best for your family, a really easy thing to do is make sure that everything that you might need is charged in case the power does go out. That's laptops, that's cell phones, that's mobile hotspots for internet if you might have something like that, and that would be tablets as well. Anything that requires a charge, a little bit of charge when the power goes out is better than not having any charge at all. That way you can stay plugged in with local news reports and you can have contact with emergency responders, friends, neighbors, loved ones, et cetera, et cetera. So here we are, and it has been a wild day, a wild Wednesday, and we are approaching the top of the hour, midnight here. We've got about inside of 10 minutes until we hit midnight. We are going to stay on the air wall to wall without commercials until we get to a point where we feel comfortable that all current tornado warnings have been allowed to expire. And Lainey, we are not there yet.
Well, actually, you know what? This just happened while you were talking. I didn't want to interrupt you. They just canceled the tornado warning for Patrick, Virginia. I want to warn everybody at home and even our crews here, if we decide we're going to come back off the air, they are watching the storm that is over northeast Wilkes County, over Elkin, the storm that is moving out of Surry, weakening. We saw that as it moved into Patrick County, so they allowed the tornado warning to expire. They're still watching the storm over eastern Wilkes as there still was some rotation with it. It continues to kind of drift north and east into southwest Surry. So I'd hate for us to come down off television, come right back on for a tornado warning for Surry. So it's possible we may just want to sit tight with this until midnight. I don't know. I don't make those kind of decisions, but that's the information I can give you all about that. What I can tell you is there is a fair decent side-by-side rotating signature here just east and northeast of Elkin over I-77, and that gives me enough concern that possibly we could have a tornado touchdown in that area. They have not put any kind of warning up for Surry County yet. I don't know whether they will or not, quite frankly, but what I do know is there is a storm there that is capable of maybe producing damaging winds, and if not that, some rotation that is high above. I think with the nighttime component to this, I just want to make sure that folks that are in the Elkin area, folks that are along I-77, and in particular, I think the direction with this, and let me see if I can get a good idea of what the direction has been with this storm. It is also kind of northeast at about 40, 45 miles an hour, it looks like. Latest position here east of Elkin along Highway 268 and also along I-77 just to the west of Highway 601. If I put a storm track on that to give you an idea, we'll give it about a 40 mile an hour speed. Some of the communities are Little Richmond, Dobson, White Plains, Mount Airy, and Cana. So they've all kind of been firing along that same plane or, you know, moving northeast, but firing just right in a row there. You can see that. Got another little blip here going off in the Weather Center. Tornado warning. They have decided to issue a tornado warning for Surry and Yadkin, so I'm glad we stuck with that, and we're going to continue to track the severe weather that is coming from these storms, the potential for tornado touchdowns. Let me turn off our little beep here because that tends to drive me crazy. And then I'll turn this attention back to the storm. All right, so here we go into Yadkin County. You saw what I showed you was that rotation that I was concerned about. And indeed, the National Weather Service out of Blacksburg concerned too. Now, I will say this is the best signature I've seen all night in our area, because what we've got, and by that, I mean best as in worst. If you're in these communities, I want you to make sure you're in your safe place. If you're east of I-77, if you're in Little Richmond, if you're in Birch, if you are along Still Meadows Lane, if you're in Lynn Drive, and let me give you some of the other communities, Joe Lane Mill Road, Stanley Mill Road, along Highway 268. So this storm is moving kind of in between Highway 268 and I-77, and it's moving northeast. So you see 77 on the left of your screen. You see 268 there on the right where Little Richmond is. This storm is going to be moving in that general direction. So if you are in the path of this storm, I want you to make sure that you are in your safe place right now. That safe place, lowest room and floor, I should say. Lowest floor, center room if you can, that's away from windows. I'm just taking you out farther so that you can get an idea of the general direction of this storm. We're in the southwestern part of Surrey County. We're east of Elkin. We're to the east of I-77. But we're not quite to Highway 601 or 268. We're kind of hovering pretty near Highway 268. There's an area there where we are seeing that rotation. And let's look at what the actual radar image looks like. Looks like a kidney bean, like we've been seeing all day long. We've just sort of seen these stills. And they don't look like the traditional ones sometimes that we get where we have this intense hail core and it's bright purple and we've got all this lightning. These are pretty different in the sense that they're just having the heavy rain component with them and just the wind shear alone. And we talked about that a little bit earlier today. And if I've got this graphically, I'll kind of show that to you because the setup that we have across the region is such that we thought this would happen because of the winds and the directions that they were going in. So I can't find it right off the bat here because there's so many things I'm scrolling through on the screen, but we've got, you know, wind at the surface that's going in one direction and wind aloft that's going in a different direction. So if you were to move your hands like that, the air between that would start to roll on its side. So usually we can get that to sort of spin up, or in a thunderstorm, if it's rolling on its side, all it takes is for a gust of wind to sort of push that column straight down to the ground. And I just push the button here, and that can cause a tornado touchdown. It can be very brief, and so that's what we're concerned about happening there in Surrey as well as in Yadkin County. And this storm moving northeast at about 45 miles an hour as well. Let me go back. I think I pushed a wrong button over here and got my computer a little bit jammed, but we'll figure it out. I do want to make sure that folks who, if you're just tuning in, if you're just waking up, maybe you've heard the noise, you've got pounding rain, or maybe you're hearing the wind gusting. If you are hearing debris hitting the side of your house, it could be gravel, rocks, any kind of debris or banging or anything, you definitely need to make sure you're in that safe place immediately. Do not hesitate. Get there, get to the basement, get to the lowest floor, get to the bathtub, cover yourself, protect yourself, grab anything you can that's soft along the way because that will help to kind of cushion you because this will be a situation where you would have to act very quickly if this did decide to touch down. So far, no reports out of Mount Airy that we had damage or a touchdown. I haven't had any reports out of Wilkes County that we had damage or a touchdown. Have yet to have any reports out of Elkin. It's a little soon that we would have any damage or touchdowns. News crews are busy trying to get that information here in our newsroom. You can see how populated this area is with the what I like to call tiny country roads that are out there between Elkin and Dobson that are off of I-77 as well as Highway 601 and Highway 268. So the Little Richmond community is there. I want to get a new update on where we have the rotation, and it does appear like it is there in Little Richmond and now maybe just east of 268 in that area. It is not as pronounced or as tight of a rotation as I saw just a couple minutes ago, which makes me think, okay, well, at least right now, it may not be as tight as an intense and may not be touching down, but there's no guarantee with this. And we have tend to see these sort of go through these waves or stages where with a supercell you might have it tightening and then it loosens again and then it tightens and then it loosens again. So there may be, as it sort of moves through that moist, unstable environment, it just kind of feeds and fuels itself. So, you know, it gets a little bit weak, and then so all of a sudden it has this new energy, sort of like if you're really, really hungry and you're kind of tired and and you eat something and all of a sudden you sort of feel this burst of energy, or maybe a marathon racer that puts like a glucose in and all of a sudden they can sort of move again a little bit faster. Well, I think that's sort of the similar environment for what's happening with this storm, is that it may start to sort of lose some of that, and then it gets into a more favorable environment where it starts to regenerate, starts to get a little bit tighter. Some of the winds may get a little bit stronger with this. Let me see what kind of wind speeds we have now. We've got pretty strong winds coming with it. Mainly, again, though, kind of looking like these winds might be unidirectional or just sort of gusts coming down out of the storm. We don't like to see too much of that because remember what I was telling you is those gusts can actually take it down to the ground. We're going to continue to sort of track the streets here, and you can see that's Cockerham Road and Chandler Road that are showing up right now. We also have Salem Wood Trail, Highway 268, Highway 601, where they intersect, that intersection there just west of Copeland, west of Stony Knoll. Those are communities that we're looking at as the potential for possible rotation that could come down to the ground. Looking at the storm, don't see a whole lot of lightning with it. We see a lot of heavy rain in the Little Richmond community over Stanley Mill Road. This is the sort of situation where you're first it's nighttime, but even in the daytime, you may not be able to see this very well as it could be kind of rain shrouded. There could be a lot of heavy rain coming down with that in that area.
So we've got about 15 more minutes for this current tornado warning, which is the one that we're focusing on, Surry County and Yadkin County. Lainey, I'm getting some questions from people now in Wilkes County who were where the folks in Surry and Yadkin are right now, maybe half an hour ago, wondering, okay, are we good? And right. I have been trying to answer as many of them as as I can on social media. You are not currently part of a warning, but good idea to be weather aware overnight, have a way to be awakened, alerted, whether that's a weather radio, whether that's a television that's on or something of that nature, so that if another warning does pop up, you're not left totally clueless and unconscious asleep at that
right.
point.
At
right. What point do you think all of this might be over, or is that the $64,000 question?
Well, I think we've got to see what this line does as the cold front comes in over the mountains. And I'm hesitant to say everything is okay in Wilkes County. What I've got here on the screen is sort of a wind shear path. So this kind of shows you. Actually, I guess we've switched to another computer. There you go. See the blue that is there from the Swan Creek that's showing up? This is showing you a path of shear or wind that possibly we could have some damage in that area. And notice how it is splotchy, like it's not one solid area, so it's just sort of flat. This is indicating that possibly there has been some sort of wind coming through that area. And the storm, of course, has tracked through that area too. Right now, it is moving over Highway 601, moving north and east. I do want to take a look and see about if we can pick up any kind of debris, having seen that. Showing the shear so well. I'm going to just do a little science here on the screen for a second, just so I can look at something, because I want to see if we're also seeing, we can pick up sometimes debris within a storm, and we were able to see it a little bit with the one in Randolph County. I don't really see that showing up here as anything that's really clear cut or showing an area where we might have some damage on the ground. So that's good. Let me check up here toward Mount Airy too. There's nothing over the last hour that jumps out at me on the screen and says, yeah, I think that we've had some sort of damage. So that is good news. Looking at the velocity right now in Mount Airy, everything looking good. Farther to the north, coming down here to this one that still pops out east of Elkin. That's why we have our tornado warning. For this area, for this broad circulation that is now getting ready to, I guess it's kind of in between Highway 268 and Highway 601. And this is an update that just came in a couple minutes ago. Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado located over Fairview, moving northeast at 40 miles an hour. So that is the storm that we're talking about here. That is in Surry County now. And we're sort of south west of Mount Airy, where Highway 601 runs past Dobson and then heads down toward the border there with Yadkin County. And we're just west of Highway 601. So that is the community of Little Richmond and Crutchfield there, where we may have a possible touchdown. We'll put in the communities of Turkey Ford and Copeland as well. They're going to continue this tornado warning. Let's see what else we've got here. Tornado canceled for Yadkin County. They're going to continue the tornado warning for Surry County, moving northeast at 40 miles an hour. Let me give you a view that you're more comfortable seeing, a little bit easier, and take you out so you can see. All right, so Yadkin County, of course, is down here just below that storm. Yadkin County was in the tornado warning. They've just taken right along the Yadkin River, the southern edge of that, so that now right in here is just Surry County. So they're going to continue that. It doesn't have a time, till 12:15. So another 10 minutes with that one. They're going to continue to watch that.
And that was the original time, I think. Wasn't for Surry? Wasn't it 12:15 to begin with? I think it was.
Oh, I'm not.
Might have been midnight. Might have been extended.
Yeah, until 12:15. No, you're right. So they're just keeping that until 12:15. You're correct, Kenny. Thanks for that. Folks, make sure you're in your safe place. If you are north of Joe Lane Mill Road, if you're at the intersection of Highway 601 and 268, that is the area that we are concerned about possibly producing a tornado.
Where 601 and 268 come together?
Correct. So it is just, it's between Dobson and Crutchfield, and not too far from the communities of Turkey Ford also showed up there, northeast of Little Richmond, not far from Blackwater. Let me go ahead and put, since you mentioned that, Kenny, a good time for me to go ahead and put on a storm track so we can tell you what is in the path of this storm. We've got northeast at about 45 miles an hour.
So another fast mover.
Oops. Now my computer wants to go haywire on me. Hold on one second. Just sit tight, folks. I will figure this out for us.
While Laney's doing that, we want to just re-up this for one more time for people who might have flipped their television sets on in the last few minutes and missed some of the things that we've been saying earlier. We have been on wall-to-wall now without commercial break uninterrupted for about the last hour. There is a tornado warning for Surry County that runs until 12:15 this evening. We have seen them earlier in the late evening hours in Wilkes County, in Yadkin County, and in some of our Virginia counties as well, Patrick and Carroll. Biggest area of concern at this time is between Dobson and Crutchfield, where 601 and 258 come together. This is a live look at radar on the right-hand side of your screen. Laney is manipulating that, her computer. The gremlins are out right now, so she's tweaking a few things. If you hear your community called, if you see your street come up on this map in some of these particularly colorful areas, as Laney's giving us an idea of where this current cell is moving in the next 20 to 30 minutes or so, that is a great time to find safe shelter. You need to be on the lowest level of your home. If you have children, not a bad idea to put helmets on them. If they have a bike helmet, if they have a football or a baseball helmet, a pillow, a mattress cover, anything that can work. If you don't have a basement, huddle up in the bathtub. Stay away from windows. We hope that this passes through without incident. So far, to the best of our knowledge, we have reached out to emergency communication folks in a number of different communities, every single one where there has been a warning. No confirmed touchdowns yet, and no confirmed reports of any damages. So, Lainey, can you get us up to speed on where we are right now? Your biggest area of concern still that Dobson-Crutchfield hotspot?
Yeah, that is the storm that we are going to continue to track, that tornado warning that is up for another 7 minutes. 12:15 is when this is set to expire. We hope that this storm continues to weaken as it goes to the northeast. That's kind of been the trend tonight, so we're hopeful for that. I want to show you some of the towns that are in the path of the storm. You've got Union Primitive Baptist Church, Blackwater, White Plains, and up toward Mount Airy in 19 minutes if it were to hold together. But more importantly, the areas that are closest here, the Blackwater community, the Simpson Hill Road, Turner Mountain Road, those are in the path of this storm. Right now, we have rotation above Simpson Hall Road, or Hill Road, sorry about that, Pratt Road. We're just southwest of Blackwater, where you can see Turkey Ford Road, Venable Road, Simpson Mill Road, Johnny Bowman Road, Rock Hill Church Road, Tom Jones Road. That is the area where this is moving very quickly. And because it is probably already past the point that I'm showing you, I'm going to go a little bit farther to the northeast. If you're on Little Mountain Church Road, if you're on Nurse Road, Golden Acres Lane, Creed Road, if you're in the Blackwater community, we need you to be in your safe place now, which is on the lowest level of the house. Pick a room that is away from windows, maybe a bathroom, an interior bathroom is a good spot to try. Also, you want to maybe go to the basement. That, if you have that, that's your first choice, actually. Otherwise, we just want you to go low. That's what we usually tell folks. Looks like we're going to get another tornado warning. They're now going to extend this into Stokes County. So for Surrey and Stokes County, until 12:45. Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado located over Ararat near Dobson, moving northeast at 40 miles an hour. Let's go back to the radar. And just an extension of this tornado warning, Kenny, in this case.
And an inclusion of Stokes County in addition to Surrey,
right.
so longer and
up,
a wider
swath. Picked up more of Surrey and then added just the western edge of Stokes County. So this is not for Stokes County over toward Belews Lake. This is for Stokes County in the extreme northwestern part of the county. It's north of King. It is up toward Francisco, as well as Pilot Mountain is sort of in the general vicinity of this. Right now it looks like Pilot Mountain would stay to the east of this storm based on the current path. If it continues to move northeast, it would look like it would go in between Pilot Mountain as well as Mount Airy. But we're still in a pretty populated area. We're right now in between Pine Hill. We're getting close to the Blackwater community. And the latest tornado warning that has come up is for Surrey and Stokes, and that is until 12:45 a.m. And one of the things that this computer is able to do is sort of estimate populations, people affected in that area of Stokes and Surrey counties. So we're looking at close to 20,000 folks that are in the dark right now, you know, maybe headed to bed, hoping they could get some sleep. And the thing with this that kind of scares me, Kenny, is that there's not lightning. There's not the thunder. There's not the noise that's going to wake you up. I know sometimes you go to bed and you hear the thunder and immediately you're up, right? Well, this is not that kind of situation. So folks, I hope in Surrey County have their weather radios on. They maybe have their apps that are waking them up, some sort of system to wake up, because that's so incredibly important at night with this. And the watch was issued before a lot of folks went to bed. We had the tornado watch issued around 8, 9 o'clock. So if you're in Surrey County, you see that tornado watch for your area. We hope that you've been sort of weather aware aware throughout the evening. You've been tuning into us maybe at 10 and 11, and you knew that there was this threat at least for the next couple of hours. When we started on the air at 10, and now we're sitting at about 12:15, and now this new warning is going to stay up until 12:45. Again, kind of moving northeast at 40 would put this between Mount Airy and Pilot Mountain. And a general track of this, we can put one on there for you. If we go northeast at about 45 miles an hour, we have Boone's Hill. We have Ararat, we have Westfield, Peters Creek, and Stewart. So those are some of the communities within the next 10, 15, 20 minutes where this will be quickly kind of moving at least nearby. Doesn't necessarily mean the tornado is going to come over that town, but it's going to be close enough to you. You definitely need to be in your safe place with that. We look at, we do still have that rotation signature showing up. With the winds that are going in opposite directions, showing wind speeds at 30 approximately to about 10 miles an hour. So not incredibly strong winds, but oftentimes if we see, you know, something that's maybe 20 miles an hour on one side, 20 on the other side, we kind of combine that and we get sort of a magnitude stronger of wind speed that's going with it, because you have to factor in that forward speed too. So we can still see some damage in that area. I want to see if we're getting any shear that is happening there. I showed you that shear track earlier. That's pretty helpful because it kind of shows you where, if we were going to have wind damage, that's where it has been taking place. And you can kind of see it's been spotty along this track. But this shows you, you know, the different areas as we've been tracking the storms. The first one that moved out of Mount Airy to the northeast, and then this one kind of shows you a trail where you're seeing that blue of where we may have had wind damage along the way, or at least the shear was pretty strong there. And if we did have a tornado that had been on the ground, let's say we had a major tornado like the folks over in New Orleans, and it was on the ground the whole time, you would see just a straight line of destruction there. What I think here is, you know, we've got some shear taking place in the atmosphere. It may have stayed up above the treetops. It may have touched the treetops. It may have stayed up in the cloud, but at least that path is showing us where that wind shear that I've been seeing, the red and green, is sort of traveling as it moves north and east. So that sort of puts it pretty close to Blackwater and now up closer to the Westfield community. Let's get a live view here real quick. I want to look at a different radar view of this. There is a little bit of lightning with this second storm, which doesn't have a warning right now, that is over Wilkes County. Also doesn't show great rotation right now, so that's good. But we'll have to keep a close eye on it, of course. Let's switch over to the other. And you can watch the storms continuing to kind of move northeast. It does look like, you know, you had some folks in Wilkes County that were asking, are we clear, are we clear, are we clear? I mean, slowly this line has kind of been moving east. It hasn't been moving super fast to the east, but if I go back about 3 hours, you can see that the forward leading cells, the ones that are kind of on the front edge of this right here, that they started a little bit farther to the west, which was about out in this area. So that the line is kind of pushing a little bit to the east. So that, you know, is worth mentioning. We still have that line kind of developing ahead of our front, which the cold front I've drawn on here has probably already moved since I drew it. It's probably closer to the North Carolina state line right now. And we've got the storms kind of tracking along that. Tornado warning still up for Surrey County, as well as that extreme western part of Stokes County. And I just got a note here I think Michelle is sort of tracking some things as well. We've been given, granted the ability to work from home with COVID, and I think Michelle may actually be up at home right now kind of tracking these storms. So I'll let the director make the call as to whether or not we want to go to Michelle and see if she's got any new information.
Anecdotally, hearing from a few people who have reached out to us via various social media, someone in the Blackwater area near White Plains reporting a lot of rain and very heavy wind. I'm hearing another beep again. Waiting to see if tornado warning. So maybe that's an extension or maybe that's another one. These are coming, gosh, about every 10 minutes now, aren't they?
Yeah, and this is just, they're going to reissue the Stokes and Surrey warning. But let's, like you said, let's have a look at it and make sure they haven't changed the location of it. And, you know, they did that with the last one, too, just to make sure. I mean, and I think that's just, you know, it's nighttime. We want to make sure if anybody has their mobile devices on or weather radio, we want to send that notice out again just to make sure that we're telling people. Because this also does mention Ararat and Pilot Mountain, and it's still Stokes and Surrey, still for the same amount of time there. So no change to that warning, still up until 12:45.
Edge of Elkin and Wilkes and Rhonda, everything very calm. Wind and a lot of rain in Mount Airy and the Flat Rock area. But again, and you know, I don't want to be overly optimistic and not sell this enough. It is the middle of the night and pitch black and would be very difficult to see. But on the flip side, I feel as if 911 centers were being inundated with calls right now, and if people were sustaining damage to their home or worse, perhaps we are far enough into this. We've been on the air nonstop for almost an hour and a half now. I feel like we would have known about it by now. That's not to say something can't still happen, but I'm feeling better about this now than I was at 11:05 when we first went on. Perhaps you are, maybe as well.
Well, I think you're right. I mean, with the lag time that comes when you have a rotation signature on the radar and then the minutes that it takes and maybe even half hours at a time before you start to get the reports in, I think you're right because we were seeing rotation over heavily populated area like downtown Mount Airy.
Right.
So I think we would have heard something easily from Mount Airy. So I'm real hopeful that we were still suspended up in the air with that rotation. And when we talk about that, the rotation taking place up in the cloud, a lot of times it can just be a rotation that's well within the storm that you can't see. Sometimes it can come down as sort of a rotating wall cloud where you see a large area sort of spinning. And then sometimes it can come down as a funnel. And we had that happen earlier today and had pictures near Archdale of our tornado warning that moved through northwest Randolph County and then moved into southern Guilford County. We did have a picture of a funnel cloud. So I was even talking with the Weather Service folks out of Raleigh about that particular storm, and we had signs of rotation. We had even debris signatures that were showing up for that storm. They were thinking we've got some damage there. It was fortunately in a kind of a rural area just east of Archdale. We sent our news crews out there, got nothing. Drove all around all the roads that were mentioned, so we're real thankful that that probably didn't touch the ground, but it was close. And that's the same sort of situation here. We don't have the visibility of daylight. We don't have folks that are up and out at 12:30 at night looking for this, but that may indeed be what's happening in this situation or the situation over Mount Airy earlier. So that's a good situation to have if you're going to have a tornado warning.
And a couple of things I just wanted to make you aware of and our viewers as well. The word from the Yadkin County Sheriff's Office is no storm damage. So we're pleased to see that. If there were major issues there, certainly by now the Sheriff's Office would know about it. And significant improvements on the North Carolina Department of Public Safety power outage map page. All of the issues, remember, it wasn't that long ago, Allegheny County had the most outages of anybody in the entire state, some 1,400. Those are now gone. Just under 1,000 outages total statewide. So the power outage issue does not appear to be a major factor at this time from all of these various tornado warnings that we've had and tornado watches that we've had. And in light of the fact that so far so good in that department. I want to bring this back to sort of front of mind here. If you are up and you are watching us and you're concerned, make sure all of your gadgets are charged. Go find the charger, put your laptop on its charger, put your tablet, put your smartphone, whatever else you might have that would really be a useful tool for you and your family in a worst case scenario. Make sure that is charging right now while you still have power. No indication that we're going to see massive power outages, but better to be safe than sorry in a situation like this. Quick little reset here. It is 12:23 in the morning on this Thursday. We have been on the air wall to wall without commercial break since about 11:05 Wednesday night due to one tornado warning after another. Some have expired, others have popped back up, and we're going to stay on the air until at least 12:45 because there is still an active tornado warning for mostly Surrey and a tiny little sliver of Stokes County. And here to give us the most recent up-to-date information on that, get us down, if need be, to the granular street level is Lainey Pope. Lainey, what are you seeing and where is this thing heading? And are you starting to feel maybe a little bit better about this one, or is that still too early to say?
Well, I'm looking at this, and that's what I'm watching, how things have been canceled here, and they're disappearing from the screen, but I want to double check. And what I mean is by the watches and warnings, I'm not seeing them showing up. I do have a report that the tornado watch has been allowed to expire for Alexander, Burke, Caldwell, Catawba, Cleveland, Gaston, Iredell, Lincoln, Polk, and Rutherford. I have not checked to see if they have dropped. They have not made any mention of the tornado watch being dropped in our area. I don't see right now the warning showing up, but I want to make sure that I am showing you the right map, because I actually have a radar that does not show warnings, and that may be the one that is on the screen right now. So let me double check that real quick, to make sure. Go ahead.
Well, you're checking that. Latest word from Wilkes County. We did just check in with them. Just a few trees and power lines down in Wilkes County. At this point, DPS showing just 12 power outages in Wilkes County. Perhaps that number is still to be updated, but at this point I would say that's encouraging. Another county, another emergency response entity saying so far so good.
Okay, and I just now have confirmation. Thanks for that, because I was able to actually read through this. They have canceled the tornado warning for Stokes and for Surrey. Also have allowed the tornado watch to expire. And we'd anticipated this, hoped for this, but as I told you about 45 minutes to an hour ago, there was no guarantee that these storms were going to weaken. They appear to be behaving like we want them to. They appear to be weakening. Even just looking at the view here across the east, now that they've come down a little farther south and east, not as intense. There's still a little bit of lightning with these. The one that is now moving up toward Elkin just has some rain and some lightning with it. I'm going to put on a still image because I do just want to double check. And the rotation, as you can see, is gone. And it's almost by magic that the magic hour wasn't midnight, but 12:30.
Right.
That everything just immediately just started to disappear on the screen. It's very bizarre, but
wow.
But
we'll take
it. If you watched at 10 o'clock, I was saying, you know, a couple of hours of this, and we do think that these storms are going to die out. Hopefully they're going to die out, and they appear to be, so that's good.
Little voice in my ear tells me Surrey County, no damage. We just made another phone call, so it crossed another county off the map. Thank goodness. Okay, so we're now in a situation, correct me if I'm wrong, where we have no active, knock on every piece of wood in the building, no active tornado warnings. We hope it stays that way.
And not only do we not have any active warnings, but we don't have anything like the last time where I saw something that might become a tornado warning.
Right.
So looking at these and just double checking them real quick, they do not have the rotation signatures that we were seeing. So I feel better about us going off the air with this and not having to jump right back on in the next few minutes. Trust me, folks, I will be here for a while longer. And if we have anything that changes, we'll come back on. But right now, I have some higher confidence in what I see that indeed what we had forecast for these to sort of fade away is going to happen. But make sure you do have that way of getting alerts just in case. We know that we try to harness and predict the weather perfectly, right. but we're not perfect at this. But I do think my best guess is that these are going to weaken like we'd hoped.
These overnight ones are the worst for sure, but as you just said, I feel better. If you feel better, I feel better, and I know if you feel better, all the folks watching at home feel better as well. Let me tell you, I can't say enough about the work that you and Michelle Kennedy and Brian did earlier today. You guys have been incredibly busy. Thanks to all of you for watching. Thank you for giving us updates through various forms, whether it was email, social media, et cetera, et cetera. We sure hope the next time we're on the air is 4:30 tomorrow morning with our regular morning show. For now, we will say goodbye. We will come back on the air if necessary, if there is another warning.
All right. Thank you.